the review of literature is the most important aspect in the research work. Okay. So equally important to the title. So you have to chosen the right title. To choose the right title, you must undergo a lot of review relevant to your that topic you are already identified. So this is the key area of research. So that is why we have chosen the review of literature for the discussion or to share our knowledge. So see the research process. The first you have to start with the statement of the problem. Stating the problem statement. If you are undertaking any research, there must be some problem. There must be some issues. For example, financial exclusion is a problem. How you are going to improve those who are excluded. So you have to state the problem statement. Or the most of the people are not aware about the Consumer Protection Act and their rights. This is the problem, this is the issue. For this, you have taken the research. So first you have to identify the problem and state the problem. For the purpose for which you have taken the title, topic, statement of the problem. And then literature. After stating the problem, now the review of literature. We will discuss elaborately in detail about the review of literature. The purpose of review the literature is to identify, to find out the research gap. So, relevant to your title, don't think nobody has studied, nobody has undertaken. No. Many people might have done already. Okay, but still, there will be some omission or missing with or without their knowledge. With or without their knowledge. In one report, no one can finish complete A to Z. It's practically not possible. Due to, your time frame, you have to finish your PhD. British full time, 2.5 years, part time, 3 years. So there is a lot of issues or problems encountered to complete A to Z. So even if you are taking a topic, definitely you cannot assure, you cannot give guarantee you are going to cover in the topic A to Z. It's practically not possible. So you have to identify the research gap. What is missing? What the researcher has not done so far, or some might have used the statistical tools but not relevant, or you can enhance or you can use the new tools for the same title. So to identify the research gap, you are going for the literature review. With the help of research gap, you can frame the research objectives. So after identifying the research gap, you are going to frame the research objectives for your topic. Okay, so again, research objectives based on the research gap. Okay, so research gap based on the review of literature. Understand? So review of literature, first you are starting with the problem statement. Okay, right. Now, research objectives. You frame the research objectives relevant to your topic. Don't have many objectives. For each, please note, for each and every objectives, you must have some analysis. Okay, just to framing the objectives and omitting that objectives in your analytical part, it's not right. So, don't go for many objectives. Restrict your objectives relevant to your title or topic. So, research objectives. And for the research objectives, fix the hypothesis, relevant hypothesis. It's an assumption. Primarily or mainly there are two types, null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Null hypothesis means that there is no relationship between age and income, for example. Okay, alternative means that there is a direct relationship between the age and the income. So mostly we are used to prefer null hypothesis. Okay, and fix the research question. To fulfill your research objectives. Now you have to fix the hypothesis and also research questions that will give you the answer for your objectives. Your research question must give the answer for your research objectives. So with the help of research question, now you are finding the answer. Okay, answer for your objectives. And then after hypothesis, now the methodology, the core. Okay, methodology includes almost all. For example, sample size, total population, what is the proposed statistical tools that you are going to follow, that we are going to adopt for your analysis. Okay, so all these things including methodology, how you are collecting your data, what is the source, primary source or secondary source, what are the methodology that you are going to adopt to collect the information or data collection. So which includes the methodology, it's most important part of the research. And then after methodology, your analysis of the study, and methodology includes the data collection. Okay, after the data collection, you are going for analysis of your data by using the appropriate or suitable statistical tools. Okay, don't use the irrelevant or the tools which is not required. You try to use the appropriate suitable tools for the analysis of your data. And after the analysis, you are starting to write your thesis. Okay. And then the last chapter, finding, suggestion and conclusion. And the last part of your the thesis or the research process is annexure and references. So these are words I view of the research process. Now we will go to the chosen title, review of literature. Now just look into the meaning for what do you mean by literature review. What do you mean by literature review? It is a process of locating, obtaining, reading and evaluating. It is most important aspect. It's a process of locating, obtaining, reading and now evaluating what they have done, how they are going to take your route, how you are going to deviate from their route. If you are doing same thing, what is the need for the same research? No need. So evaluate their strength and weakness in the particular article or particular thesis or particular report and deviate from their route. So evaluate the existing literature in the area of your interest or the area of the researcher interest. So it's a process of locating, obtaining, reading and evaluating the existing literature in the area of researcher interest. And also it will show that the researchers have learned from other literature and their research is starting point. So only by review of literature you are starting your research work. Okay, so by getting that huge amount of knowledge. Okay, so this is the starting point of new ideas. Next, the purpose of literature review. What is the purpose? What is the purpose of review of literature? First, to identify the research gap. To identify the research gap. What is missing? What is missing? Already I have told you. A researcher cannot cover A to Z in a title. It is practically not possible. Or sometimes lack of knowledge for the researcher. Omission because of lack of knowledge, lack of experience. So you are finding out, you are identifying the research gap. And also, I have told you, don't think in your topic only you are the pioneer in doing the research work. Nothing. We cannot say nobody has done in my topic, in my title. Don't use that word, nobody. Might be a few researcher has done. Okay, so duplication of existing concept will be avoided. Don't use the already somebody has done. So duplication of existing concept will be avoided by having the literature review. And the third point, the other people working in the same field can be identified. For the other person doing the same title, so that you can exchange the knowledge, share the knowledge and avoid the duplication. And avoid the nothing wrong in discussing. But you can both the works must be deviated, must be distinguished from each one. So the other people working in the same field can be identified. To identify the same work being done by the other people. And readers' knowledge will be updated. only by reading the literature, I mean reading the articles, thesis, the dissertation or any other literature, you are updating, you are enhancing your research knowledge. Okay, so reader's knowledge will be updated and the researcher will come out with a new idea or theory. Okay, after reading all, now you are coming to the conclusion, I am going to take my route like this. Okay, so after identifying the research gap and to avoid the duplication and to know the people who is working in the same field can be identified, and you have updated your knowledge, and now finally you are taking your new route, that is new idea or a theory. If you are following the same thing, there is no need for undertaking the new research, I mean research by you. So your idea must be a new one, your theory must be a new one. You have to take your route take a new route, right? Sources of literature review. Okay, what are the various sources of literature review? Primarily there are three sources. One is primary source, secondary source, tertiary source. There are three sources. Now let us discuss what is primary, what is secondary, what is tertiary, one by one. If you are collecting the literature from these sources, it is called primary sources. So original document containing first-hand information about a topic, autobiographic, diaries, interviews, if you are interviewing with the others, that is a primary source. And then letter, reading, or even now you can write a letter. You can read the letter already, receive. And then original works of art, and then photographs, speeches. If you are referring all these called primary sources. So try to refer all these things from this, which is also most important for your research. And then secondary sources. It contains a discussion and interpretation of primary sources, bibliographics, dissertation, and then indexes, abstract, bibliographies that we are using to locate a secondary source. We are using all these things to locate the secondary sources and the journal articles. If you are using all these things, that is called secondary source of literature. And the third one is tertiary. It's a combination of both primary and secondary. It's a combination of both primary and secondary sources. It presents summary of materials, usually with the references of primary and secondary sources. They rarely contain original material. Dictionaries. Do you think that is original? No. If you find any word, the origin may be different countries. So, dictionaries is a tertiary source. Directories, telephone directory. Okay, first they are collecting the information from the customer. Okay, and then they are printing and then publishing. So, it's an example for tertiary sources. Encyclopedias, handbooks, fact books, user contributed online resources, especially Wikipedia. These are called tertiary sources. Next, types of literature review. There are four types of literature review, namely traditional review. Traditional, that's what we are following. Traditional review says that critically evaluate, analyze and summarize literature. Just critically evaluate the thesis or articles, analyze and summarize literature. And then identify the research questions, and the solution should be identified by the researcher. You can identify the research question by having traditional review, but only the researcher has to identify the solution. Solution should be identified by the researcher. That is the meaning for the traditional review. And systematic review. Systematic review says that identify all the literature in the topic area to ensure that no existing knowledge is missed. No existing knowledge is missed. You have covered. So you have updated. I mean the knowledge in the selected topic by the researcher. Okay, you have not left any knowledge, any idea of the topic you have selected. and then provide answers to the question about what works and what does not work. So here, you have identified the research question and you have to identify the solution. Traditional review. But systematic review, provide answer to the question and what works and what does not work. So you can get the answer, what is good, what is not good. What is good, what is not good. What works and what does not work. This is feasible, this is not feasible. And then we'll continue the types. The third one is meta-analysis. Meta-analysis. Take the findings from the chosen literature. Findings, please note. Take the findings from the chosen literature and then analyzing these findings by using standardized statistical procedures. So now you have take the findings from the chosen literature and you are analyzing these findings by using the standardized statistical procedures and help in drawing these meta-analysis, help in drawing conclusions and deducting statistical models and relationship between findings, that is correlation. Okay, so when you are using the correlation, you can find the relationship between findings. And then meta-synthesis. This is a non-statistical procedure. This is statistical. You are using the, so the difference is, this is a statistical procedure, this is a non-statistical procedure. We are not using any statistical tools. So it evaluate and analyze findings from the qualitative, theoretical, qualitative studies and aims to interpret the existing literature. So this is a non-statistical procedure. It evaluates and analyzes findings from qualitative studies and aims to interpret the existing literature. So these are the four types. Just remember, tell me, what are the four types of literature?
Traditional.
Systematic.
Meta.
Analysis.
Meta-synthesis.
Just tell me the difference between the meta-analysis and meta-synthesis. Please sit, sit, sit.
Meta-analysis, based on the findings, we have to gather the data.
Based on the, what are findings only? Meta-analysis, we are using the statistical tools. Here, this is a non-statistical procedure. It evaluates and analyzes findings from qualitative studies and aims to interpret the existing literature. So these are the main difference between the meta and the meta-analysis, meta-synthesis. And then elements of literature review. Elements of literature review. First elements is introduction. So gives a quick idea of the topic of the literature review, like central theme and the scope of the research. So elements, the first one is introduction. Gives a quick idea of the topic of the literature. Okay, your topic of the review. Review of literature. So topic of the literature review, like central theme and the scope of the research. And then the second elements of the literature review, the body, which contains the discussion of the data collection and data analysis sources. So discuss, now you have started discussing data collection, how they have collected the data and their analysis, I mean the sources, data analysis sources. Last one, you have to conclude by yourself. Discuss what you have drawn from reviewing literature so far. Don't write whatever they have written. Now, draw a conclusion by the researcher. So there is the conclusion. Conclusion part again, don't just copy from the other's one. Draw the conclusion by the reviewer. Now we have identified the gap. Oh, this is missing. This tool is not used. This is not a better tool. Likewise, you conclude and take the deviate your book. Now the process of literature review. Process of literature review. The first process, define your research topic. Define your research topic. That is, what your research is all about. what your research is all about. That is the meaning for define your research topic. Follow that. Identify your information sources. Now you are going to identify your information sources. Just now we have discussed either you are going to have the primary source or secondary source or tertiary source. Followed by collect and read the literature. Now start that. Okay, here you have to start literature review. How? Read the abstract of an article first to check whether it is relevant to your research. Read the abstract of an article first to check whether it is relevant to your research. By reading the abstract, you can draw the conclusion it is relevant to your topic or not. If it is irrelevant, just don't read. But for the knowledge set, you can read. But for the research purpose, I think you can stop reading if the abstract is not relevant to your topic. Understand? And then evaluate and organize the reviews. Now evaluate and organize the reviews. Identify the research gap. Reading more articles will help to identify the research gap. So now evaluate and organize the reviews. So already we have discussed it. The purpose of literature is to identify the research gaps. What is missing in the particular article, in the particular thesis, in the particular topic. So identify the research gap. Reading, to identify the research gap, you have to read more and more. We'll come back, we'll discuss more about this. And the last one is cite the sources. Don't forget to cite the sources. Otherwise, if you have failed to cite the sources, your work is called, uncited source is called plagiarism. It is copied. Copied. If you have failed to quote, if you fail to cite the reference material in your report, that source, that indicates you have copied. So don't forget to cite the sources. Or else, otherwise, uncited sources is called a plagiarism, just copied from other. So acknowledge if you have referred, if you have used the material from others' work by means of cite the sources. Next, how to organize the reviews collected? How to organize? How to write review of literature? How to organizing the reviews collected means how to write your report. The typical ways of organizing the source into your review are chronological order, that is alphabetical order. Yeah, what is your name? Charyan Thomas. Your name?
Balasubramanian.
Rajalakshmi. Maniyanan. You arrange in the alphabetic order. Balasubramanian. Arrange your name in the alphabetic order.
Balasubramanian. Then Charyan Thomas. Next. Rajalakshmi and Manikant. Manikant and Raj.
So chronological order. Now tell me what is your name? Rajalakshmi. Arrange the scholar in the alphabetical order. Arrange the scholars in the alphabetical order. Sherry,
Balasubramanian.
Sherry
Thomas.
Why least importance to the girl? Why least importance to the, why your name is appearing in the last?
My alphabetical order.
Yes. According to alphabetical order, see your name is R, so it appears in the, appears as a last one. So arrange your review according to the chronological, otherwise alphabetical order, A, B, C, and so on. Second one is by publication, year-wise. Latest first or some review, some work they are starting from, for example, latest now. I mean the latest first means here, you are saying first 2014 and then 2016, 15, 14, am I right? Or otherwise you can start for example 90, 2000, 2014, same thing. So some others or some researchers, they are using this method also. Now they are at the end, they are updating. So these are review in the year. The latest one is they are showing the first one. I mean, the last one. Okay, so by publication year wise, but according to this theory, latest is the first. For example, current year, what is the current year? 2016. First. Then 2014. 15, 14, and so on. Right. The third, I mean, are mentioning the reviews collected is trend, methodological. The trend means, for example, from first generation computer to tablet personal computer. Okay, according to that, trend, methodological. So we have taken the example of computer. You take any product, any service. So from the trend, how the product have been developed, the model, the example. So from invention till recent development, there is organizing by trend or methodological. The last one is thematic. Organize the reviews according to the themes. Organize the reviews according to the themes or objectives. For example, about Make in India or Go Green India. So organize your review according to the theme or objectives. For example, Make in India or Go Green India. Now, the common errors in collecting literature review. Common errors. The first error is the range of collecting reviews will be limited, restricted only to national literature. Only national literature are reviewed and international literatures are not reviewed. So the range of collecting reviews will be limited to only India or only the country. That is not acceptable. You have to take both national and international review. So in general, the peoples are restricting their review only to the respective country. For example, a researcher in India, they are restricted only reviews of literature in India. That's not right. So your review must be national and international. Don't restrict your research review of literature only national studies. Go for studies in abroad. Studies in abroad. So don't forget to have some literature review for your study covering both national and don't forget national. We are not asking to concentrate only international. Concentrate both national and international reviews. And substandard articles will be reviewed, which will provide way or conclusion in the idea. So don't go for reviewing the substandard article, substandard thesis, substandard works. Refer standard. That's what we are insisting. Insisting have some international review. Why? To have standard. So avoid substandard articles, review the substandard articles, which may lead to confusion, in your ideas. So obviously the outcome will not be a good one. Your input is wrong, obviously your output is also wrong. Then irrelevant sources are searched. Remove the irrelevant sources. The sources which are not relevant to your topic, remove. But for the knowledge purpose, you can read. But you cannot incorporate, you cannot take it into account for your research work. So avoid irrelevant sources or search. Don't search for irrelevant resources for your topic. And then don't omit, update your knowledge by recent works. So in general, the researchers are omitting the recent development, recent works, recent articles published. So update your knowledge, update your idea by referring the recent articles, recent thesis, recent works to update your knowledge. So recent works are omitted, information even 2 years old would be obsolete. So for if you are referring 2014 or 2013, that is outdated. To update, refer the works published in 1516. We are in 2016. So you have tried to refer 2016 also. Don't omit the works of 2015 don't omit the exam, latest. Latest which is most important to enhance, to update, that to know the trends, latest trends in the particular area of research. So recent works are omitted, but it's not good. It is not advisable. Take into account the recent works to enhance, to update your research knowledge. Then focus on the language. Now create a balance between direct quotation, that is citation. Direct quotation means citation and interpretation. Avoid too much direct quoting. He says, Sri Ram says, Sharyam Dhamma says, Balasupram says, what you say. Understand? Don't quote, you can quote, but avoid too much direct quoting. Right? And then, when you are citing a specific author's findings, use the past tense such as found, demonstrated, identified, evaluated. Okay, use the past tense. When you are citing a specific author's findings, use the past tense such as found, demonstrated. When you are citing several others, more than one other, others are making a general statement, use the present perfect tense such as have shown, have found. Little research has been done. Okay, so have shown, have found. So use the, this language when you are citing several others. Now the major difference between bibliography and reference. Can I get the answer from Balasubramanian from me? What do you mean by bibliography? What do you mean by reference? Don't refer the book.
Bibliography means we find some books.
Sit, please.
We find some books based on that books. Last we can put a bibliography.
Find some books, which book?
Books are articles.
Okay.
Refer on these things.
Reference?
Reference means we find data from
bibliography. Okay, Sharyam Thomas, bibliography and reference. The major difference between the bibliography and reference. You might have heard the word both, but it is wrong to hear the word without knowing the meaning for the term bibliography and reference.
Reference are authors who have directly contributed to your study.
Okay.
Bibliography are authors who have not directly contributed. They would have just provided you the information, but whenever you quote, it is reference authors whom you got. You will never quote other authors.
Good. So bibliography, just you have read, referred, understand, but you have not directly used that work. You read and you have updated your knowledge, enhanced your knowledge, but that sources are not used in your report, not used in your article, not used in the thesis. A bibliography inputs details of all the resources used to produce the assignment. But again, by reading, by evaluating, by understanding their work, you have produced the assignment. But you have not directly quoted anything else from the, the books or article. Just you have read. Understand, you have evaluated, but you have nothing have been taken from that resources. It is called bibliography, which are not cited in the in-text. So bibliography, no need to cite, since you have not taken anything as it is from that work, from their work, from their article, from their thesis. Okay, just read for the knowledge sake. And you have not taken, you have not reproduced again, from their work to your work. Okay, just to enhance, to update your ideas, knowledge, right, that's all. Okay, but we cannot say whatever we have read is not at all useful. No, we have expanded your knowledge. Reading might be helped you to write your thesis, but you have not reproduced what they have quoted in your thesis. You have not directly quoted what they have written in their report. But the reference contains only the work cited in text that appears in the reference list, and each entry in the reference list must be cited in text. Reference, definitely you have reproduced something. You have reproduced something from the article you have read, thesis you have read, whatever the source. So some part, a part of the work have been reproduced, you have used in your article or in your report. Now you have to cite. You have to quote the reference. Failing which, what do you mean by, suppose you fail to quote the reference, what do you mean? You have referred and also you have quoted their works in your report or thesis, but you have failed to quote the reference. Now what do you mean?
Plagiarism.
Copying. Since you have, correct, but word is different, correct. We have failed to acknowledge. These are the part of the work done by Mr. X, Mr. Y. This work is taken from Mr. Y's work, Mr. X's work. Phase 2 to cite this plagiarism that is not acceptable in the report for the research work. In-text citation. So it helps readers to easily find the sources in the reference section that correspond to your referenced passage. So in-text citation. Suppose phase 2 you have referred, page number 5, you have taken a part of the work from Thierry and Thomas. Page number 5, you have tried, you have tried number or his name. And at the end, you have tried the reference details. So that you can quickly know the part of the Thierry and Thomas work. Okay, so it helps readers to easily find out. So then and there, you quote the number or name. Other sources. Initially, suppose you have 10th page, you have taken from the work of, what is your name?
Rajalakshmi.
In the 10th page, you have tried either Rajalakshmi name or give the number for the Rajalakshmi. The same number should be quoted in the reference so that we can easily identify who told and in which page. So, it helps readers to easily find out the sources in the reference section that corresponds to your referenced passage, and then it varies according to different reference type. So we have different style. Just I have told you to explain to make you to understand. We have different style. We will see later. And then without in-text citation, reader cannot identify the source of review. Suppose you fail to cite. You have given only at the end of the report references. In your thesis report, first page, first chapter, second chapter, third chapter, no reference. Are you able to identify where you have referred, where actually you have taken from the other's work? You cannot identify. So, without in-text citation, reader cannot identify the source. So, in-text citation is mandatory to identify who has contributed this work. Just furnishing the reference at the end of the report, no use at all. Uncited reviews, already we have told, plagiarism, copied. And then, now, plagiarism, just to look into the word, the meaning for the word, plagiarism. Plagiarism is using others' ideas and words without clearly acknowledging the source of that information. We have used, we have reproduced, we have taken, but fails to acknowledge, fails to cite, just to be out, unsite, fails to cite. If you fail to taken from others' work but fails to cite, that means you are claiming your work but already done by others. It means plagiarism. So if you have used others' work, you just acknowledge. Okay, that acknowledge means reference. And then to avoid plagiarism, the following must be cited. So you have to cite the following items. If you wanted to say, I have not copied, you have taken, but you have acknowledged. Sources, okay, reference. So another person's idea, opinion, theory. So avoid plagiarism. The following must be cited. You have to cite. If you have used the other's idea, other's opinion, other's theory, or else copy. Okay. Suppose you have cited, acknowledge it. It's not a plagiarism. And any facts, if you have used any facts or statistics, graphs, drawings, any piece of information that are not common knowledge, again you have to quote. Quotations of another person's actual spoken or written words. So quotations of another person's actual spoken or written. Suppose if you have taken the actual speech of Prime Minister or President, you have to quote. Or any Chief Minister or Governor or Reserve Bank of India Governor, quote the person. If you have taken their actual speech or actual words, you have to quote. Or else plagiarism. It is not the word of yours. The owner is the person who spoke, who written, not you. Okay, nothing wrong to use the speech of the prominent persons. President of India, Prime Minister of India, Governor, any state Governor, or Governor of RBI. But don't forget to quote, cite, reference. Any plagiarism, this is most important, even in our VIT University, this is mandatory. So before submitting your synopsis, you have to submit the plagiarism check. I think here acceptable is 15, less than 15%. 12%. Suppose your plagiarism person is more than 12%, the university won't permit you to submit your report. So plagiarism 12% means what?
88%.
12% taken from other source. So your contribution must be at least 88%. So ensure your plagiarism report is not exceeding 12% to submit your report. Then reference type. There are many styles are there. Even VAT, we have our own style. Please refer the website, VAT style. To write your report, you have to follow this style, VAT reference style. Okay, so vat.ac.in/research/academic/programs. You can understand what is the reference type for the VAT University to write your PhD report. Understand? And then come to the first one, APA, American Psychological Association. If you are clicking or if you are using this website, you can understand American Psychological Association reference style. And the other side, MLA. Expansion for MLA. What is the expansion for MLA? You was a Bhaji Rajeshwari.
Modern language association.
I am asking for expansion for MLA. State government MLA.
Number of
MLA. Boss only. Expand MLA.
Regarding politics.
Expand MLA. Chirin Thomas.
Member of Legislative Assembly.
Member of?
Legislative Assembly.
Good. Member of Parliament is MP. Okay. So here MLA, Modern Language Association. Modern Language is a reference type. So APA, MLA, for this please refer this website. Okay. And then Chicago, again we have another style. But the journal or the institute may ask you to follow any one method, according to their need, according to their requirement, according to their demand. Choose the method. VAT, we have our own method of writing the reference. And then Chicago, then Harvard. Then,
Van?
grant cover. So another method. Okay, so please go down at the website address and then use and try to learn all the reference styles. If you are writing the article for a particular journal, they may ask you to follow Chicago method. Your reference style must be based on the Chicago or Harvard or APA or MLA. So it differs from journal to journal, institute to institute. So better to learn as many reference styles as possible. But don't forget our own style for your PhD thesis writing. But to write the article for different journal, they may ask you to follow any one method. Okay? Right. Reference styles. And please just go through a sample literature review. How to draft the literature. First part, reading, introduction of the review with the scope, the green, the themes covered, the body of the review, and then blue, your conclusion remarks. So conclusion of the review with the focus, right? This is your part. Okay, so these three must contain while writing the literature review. So just read how they have got sample literature review. Including scope. This is the body of the review and conclusion. So don't copy, don't take as it is from the work done by others. What is your remark? Here, your concluding remark, your own contribution. So this is how you have to write the literature review. Now the time for question answer. Okay, you have question, we have answer. Understand what I have told. You have a question, and what is the next statement I have given? You have a question.
We have the answer.
I have not told.
I have
answer. Okay. Fine. Now.